Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. In this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 41 for our valuable viewers. In today's course coverage, we will be focusing again on the differential method. Previously, we have used numerical method, and today we will be using the polynomial fit to determine our parameters such as reaction rate constant and order of the reaction. The procedure will remain the same as that of the numerical method. So we will just focus on the calculations of minus dc over dt, and rest of the procedure is same as that of the numerical method. I am giving its link in the pop-up, which will be showing to you now. So let's quickly recap what was the example which was given to us, that there are two reactants A and B, which produces the product C and D. We are given that B is in excess, which is methanol, and the reaction is first order with respect to methanol, and we have to determine the order of species A. Obviously, using integral method and numerical method, we have already proved that it is second order with respect to species A, and now today we are using the polynomial fit. This data of time versus concentration is given to us, the time at each interval of 50 minutes, and corresponding the values of concentration are given, and these values are CA into 10 raised to the power 3. It means that if we need to calculate the CA, we have to divide each value by 10 raised to the power 3 or 1000. So going to the polynomial method, which is another method to determine the value of dCA over dt. Now how we can do it, that we have to first find the equation in terms of this, like CA is equal to A naught plus A1T plus A2T square up to so on, ANT raised to power N, and then we have to take derivative of it, and then we have to substitute the values in it. Now this is the real time solution available over here, but for this we need to go to the Excel sheet. We need to find out how we can come to these points, and then we can get this table as shown to you here. So let's quickly go to the Excel sheet. Now this is the main Excel sheet, as you can see here, but I will do it one by one to show you that how it is built. So first we will go to this data, that time versus concentration data is given to us. So first thing is to draw a plot between these two, like selecting the x-axis, then control from keyboard y-axis, going to this insert and drawing the plot, and this plot is generated over here. Now we are using the polynomial fit, so we have to use the trend line option by right clicking on it, add trend line, going to the polynomial, and we can simply display equation and display r square value on the chart. Now this r square value is 0.993. The more this value will be, the better is the data fit. So what we can do, we can increase the order, like if you go to 3, it is 0.9997, and if we take it to 4, it is 1. So this will be our polynomial equation which we will be using. Now you can see it is y is equal to 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 9, x raised to the power 4 minus 3 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 into x raised to the power 3 plus 0.0013 into x raised to the power 2 minus 0.2978 into x plus 49.99. This is the constant, and other values are linked with the variable x. This x is obviously the time, and this y is CA into 10 raised to the power 3. You have to keep it in mind that 10 raised to the power 3 will definitely come over here with y, while with t we will be using the values. Now we have just copy pasted the trend line over here, that CA into 10 raised to the power 3 is equal to this value. If we want to calculate the CA, we have to simply divide each term by 1000. So accordingly, you can see that CA is equal to 0.04999, as you can see this one, then minus 2.978 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 into t, plus 1.343 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 into t square, this one, then minus 3.485 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 t cube, this value, and this final value 3.679 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 t raised to the power 4. Obviously these are just rounded off values. Once you take it out from the scientific figures, you will see that this is the total solution. And now to calculate dc over dt, we have to take the derivative of it. Obviously, if you remember that this value dc over dt into 10 raised to the power 4, which we have used, so we will differentiate this equation with respect to time t. So this 49.99, obviously it will be 0 because it's a constant. This will become as minus 0.2987. Then 0.0013 into 2, so 0.002687 into t, then 3 into minus 6 into 3, this one, 4 into this one. So we have now calculated all the values. Over here, this is a screenshot from book, but you can see that we have got the answer of 0.2978 actually. So we will be using the value of 0.2978 when we will be writing the formulas in our system. So now going to main sheet, you can see this result is already given to us, but I will do it one more time. Like what is given to us, minus 0.2978, that is minus 0.2978 plus 0.002687 into t, which is this one, first value. Obviously applying bracket is good thing so that the formulas are not disturbed. Then minus 1.045 e of minus 5 into t raised to power 2, then plus 1.479 e of minus 8 into this raised to power 3. So minus 0.298 or 2.978, you have to simply drag it and you can see you got the answer from here. And this answer approximately matches with the previous answers as shown in the numerical method. So this is how you calculate DC over DT to 10 to the power 3, and you have to, if you have to convert it to minus DC over DT into 10 to the power 4, you have to take minus from this side and you have to multiply both sides by 10, obviously. So this will be 2.978, 1.877, 1.188, 0.8, 0.60, 1.481, and 0.329. So after that, you have to simply draw a plot and you have to find the value of K prime, and obviously you have to find the value of the reaction order. And the procedure obviously will remain the same as that of the numerical method. The pop-up link will be showing to you here, and you can go to the numerical method video and you can see how we have done that part over there. Obviously that will be the duplication, so I'm just avoiding it in this video. So I hope you have understood all the aspects of this video. In the next lecture, we will be using the polynomial fit using the polymath. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.